Welcome back to the SST classroom. How are you all? I hope you all are feeling fine. Okay, now my dear children, on Monday we have started our new chapter, right? That is lesson number 7, Indian Lifestyles. Okay, we have discussed about the introduction of this lesson. So what I told today, in the next video we are going to discuss. Today we are going to discuss about the food of different regions. Okay, so are you ready? Now let's start. First we'll see, in the North India, wheat is grown in a large quantities. You know, the North India, you see the map, the North India. So in this region, the wheat is grown in a large quantities. And why? Because of a perennial river which flow in the North India, and here the soil is very good for growing crop like wheat. So it is a staple diet of the people of North India. As you know, chapatis are made from wheat. Chapatis are made from wheat flour and are eaten with the cooked pulses and vegetables. So this wheat is a staple diet. What is the meaning of staple? Means the diet which is eaten in a more quantity, which is eaten regularly. That is known as staple diet. So as I told you that wheat is grown in a large quantities. So what is the staple food of the North India? Wheat. Wheat is a staple food of North India. And with this wheat flour, with the chapatis, they are eating the vegetables and pulses. Got it, my children? Now let's talk about we'll see which states are the leading producer of wheat. You know what is leading producer? Means the first one who produce this wheat in a large quantities. So the states like Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Punjab and Haryana, these states are the leading producer of wheat and sugar. This is the state which produce wheat and sugars in a large quantities. Got it, my children? Now let's talk about the next stage, that we will talk about the Eastern India. Okay, now in the Eastern and the Southern India, people, they mostly have rice in their diet, because here in this state the rice is grown in a large quantity. So in the Eastern and the Southern states of India, people, they mostly have their rice in their diet. Okay, now in the Eastern India, milk dish are most popular. Your mother also cook the milk dishes. So what are made from milk dishes? Many things are made from milk dishes. So here the milk dishes are very popular. So what they are making up from the milk, that is sandesh, rasgulla. Can see the picture? Sandesh, rasgulla and chum chum are very popular in the East India. Oh my god, students, you are having more water in your mouth, right? So by looking at this rasgulla, chum chum and sandesh, these dishes are most popular in the Eastern states of India. Got it, my children? And also rice and fish is also eaten in the Eastern India. As I told you that in Eastern and the Southern state, the mostly the people, they have a rice and also fish in their diet. Got it, my children? Hope till here you have understood about the Northern states and the Eastern states. states of India. Right? Now let's talk about the in southern state. Which dish is most popular, you know? You are also having most popular dish of southern India. That is idli dosa, right? So this is the most popular dish in the southern India. Like idli, dosa, sambar, steamed rasam, etc. are the most popular dish in the southern states of India. Got it, my children? Hope you have understood till here. What do we discuss right now? We discuss about the North India, which is grown in a large quantity and it is a staple diet of the North India. Then we discuss about the East India and Southern state. Right? Here also the rice is grown in a large quantity. Got it, my children? And we discuss about the Eastern state milk dish, our most popular dish. So from the milk, what they are making? We are making the rasgulla, you know, rasgulla, which is made from the milk, right? And chamcham, sandesh. This is the most popular dish in the eastern India. And in the southern states of India, like idli, dosa, sambar, steam, etc. are the most popular dish in the southern states of India. Got it, my children? Hope till here you have understood about the food different region. Now, people of North India prefer to have wheat in a large quantities, right? Whereas the people in the southern state, in the eastern and southern state of India, they have a rice in a large quantities. You know which states come in eastern and southern states of India? That is Orissa, West Bengal, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, etc. These states comes in eastern and southern states of India. So here the rice are eaten in a more quantities. And rice is grown in a large quantities in the eastern and southern states of India. Now, if you talk about the Rajasthan, Jawar, Bajra, wheat are more popular in the states of Rajasthan. Got it? Now, my dear children, you might be have heard about the Makhai ki roti and Sarso ka saag. Where you have heard in this state, mostly the people have makhai ki roti and sarso ka saag. Can you tell me? That is in Punjab. Mostly the people they have makhai ki roti and sarso ka saag. This is a popular dish in Punjab. Indian food is different from rest of the world. You know, if you go any of the world, any of the country, but the food taste of our country is more good than any other country. Not only in taste but also in cooking method. Got it, my children? Hope you have understood about today's topic, that is food of different region. Got it? I hope you have understood about the food of different region. So in the next video, my dear children, we are going to discuss about the vegetables and fruits. We are going to see that which states produce which fruits and famous and which is the famous fruit in which states. Okay? So by the time, what you are going to do? You have to read the textbook and underline the new words. Underline the important points. Okay? Thank you.